What's happening, brainy folks? So today we're going to build a portfolio website completely without code. Well, we're going to code, but we're going to ask AI to do all of the coding work for us, from writing the code to deploying and having the live website. So let's get started. First tool we're going to use is v0.dev. This is something recently launched by Vercel. It's been out there, but the newest version with chat functionality is released recently. So we're going to give a prompt and we'll ask to build a portfolio website. I am going to provide resume for it to take the content from. Not traditional, but why not? So I'm going to copy paste a resume in here. One could also attach a copy, and I think it just takes images. So I have PDF. I'm going to give all of the info from my resume, and I ask in the prompt to make it stunning with animations, visuals, gradients, anything that you would like on your website. So I'm going to send that info. It's going to start generating a UI. So this was also something released by Claude before, where you can look at artifacts, and in real time, as the UI is displayed, we can see what's happening. Oh wow, look at that. There are some animations happening. Okay, I'm not so happy. How about we add some additional things here? I'm asking for it to make it sectional and don't show kid-like animations, and also have maybe some additional effects that I wanted to build in the app. So let's see what happens. Okay, so this is the version 2 that it came out with, and this is amazing. I can see that it has the sections, it has the experience, skills, education. Looks really nice, so I'm satisfied. I'm going to take the code and I am gonna go to the next step. Next, I'm gonna open a folder in Cursor. I create a project called Portfolio. That's what I'm gonna open here. It's completely blank, as you can see. So the key things over here. Now in Cursor, the way it works, you have the regular folder structure, like in any code editor on the left side. And then you can, of course, bring up your terminal at the bottom. And then something that is gonna be important to us is the chat functionality. So here's where we're gonna ask for update changes, ask for step-by-step instructions, or anything that we want to ask about the project. Now, if you're installing and running Cursor for the first time, you might be asked to create an account. Now, you can go to settings, and in general, you might want to create an account. I recently created an account, so I have a trial which is available now for all users, and that trial gives us access to Anthropic models, which is something that we're going to be using now. So we're going to be using Claude 3.5 Sonnet. There are some rules for AI in place. This is, to my understanding, default. I don't think I've changed this. And then a few additional things. I haven't changed much here, so I'm just going to go with all defaults that's available in here. And then I'm going to paste the code that I had from V0. And also I'm going to give a little bit of instructions at the top saying that this is the code I was given. Make it deployable with Next.js, and also assume I have no coding background. And also give me step-by-step instructions on how to get started, all commands, as well as how to deploy the website. So that's basically it. I'm gonna hit enter. So now we can see all of the steps. Those are provided to us to install the Node.js. This is something I already installed, so I'm not gonna do that. But if you're doing first time, go ahead and do that. And then in our terminal, which we have open here, we can run these commands. So there are two ways. You can either copy paste and run it, or you can allow it to run by itself. So if I were to hit run, it's gonna run those commands for me. Now, sometimes you're gonna notice that if it is a command like this, which requires a yes, no question, then it might not work. So what I'm gonna do is I'll just take the command, I'll paste it there. And then in here, I'm gonna say yes, and it's gonna install. Now there are a few options that we're gonna be asked. So that's the good thing that Cursor knows that it's gonna be asked. So we're gonna go through each of those and say if we want to run it or no. So in this case, I'm just gonna follow exactly what it said. Okay, I followed all of the instructions. I'm gonna hit enter, and that's where it's gonna create this new project for us. Now that's a success. I'm gonna follow the next step, which is to cd or change directory and go into that directory. So that's what happened. Now I'm gonna run these commands. So I'm gonna copy as is. Since it is a one line command, I'm just gonna run it, and it's gonna do the installation for us. And next is, now it says to create the folders, files and folders. So if we were to look into our directory, there's a bunch of stuff that's happening over here, right? So if you come from a coding background, then you know what's happening, but I'm going to assume that you are coming from a no-code background just to make it simple for everyone. So in here, it says that the components folder, create a new folder called UI. I'm going to try to see where is the components folder. So I don't see it there and I don't see it there. So I can ask Cursor that I don't see the components folders. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask at the bottom that, you know, I don't see the components folder. And not just that, I am going to add some context. Well, right now you see that there is no file open. So by default, Cursor is going to take the file that's open as context. But if you don't, what you could do is you can provide context from a website or some documentation or maybe a repo. Also, you can take context from the full code base. Not just that, files, folders, there are a bunch of things that you can do with that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take the code base, and based on that, I'm going to ask the question. So now what's going to happen is it is reading all of the files in here, and it will understand the structure. And now it's going to know by itself that, okay, there is no components folder. So let's do something else. Okay, I apologize for the confusion. So this is what you're going to notice, that there is a chance that it might first give you some commands or some way of doing things, which might not work. Don't worry about it. Just ask Cursor and just give it context of the code base. Most likely, it will just go through it and give you some new commands. All right, so it's asking us to create a components folder in the root of your project. Now, it's also given us instructions on how to do it. So right now, it had asked us to change directory. Now, I'm going to follow the instructions and do exactly what it asks us to do. Now, it could have ran the whole thing as run, but that's fine. I copied two of those before, so I'm just going to run. All right, great. So let's see where those are. So I can see it. It's in the components folder, and in UI, we have those elements. Now it tells us to go to each of those and add some code. So I can just open button in this case and hit play here. If it doesn't recognize the file, then it's probably going to ask you that it did not predict an origin for the file. So in that case, I know this is the right file. I'm just going to say yes, and it will go ahead and add the code for us. Now, next step, I'm going to go to card, same thing. I'll just hit run and then say yes, and it will add the code for us. Great. Now it says to continue where you left. So I'm going to go back up here. And in here, I can see that after the components folder instruction, there was the command to add button and card. And then now we go back to the main page, and this is within pages index.js. So that's exactly what I'm going to look for within the pages folder. I'm going to look for index.js. I'm going to look at the next set of instructions. It gives us instruction what to import and also rest of the code and some other component code. I'm going to copy this, and I am asking Cursor that I don't understand what code to add and where and what to do with the index.js file. Just give me the full code, right? So I'm just going to hit enter and let's see what it does. Great. Now I see that it went through the whole file and it just gave the full code for us. So what I'm going to do is I'll just go ahead and apply that to our index.js file. Awesome. So we see that it made the changes. All of the green code is the one that it added. Everything in red is that is taken out, and that's fine. We're just going to accept. I mean, we'll see what happens. I'm just going to save that with Command S or Control S in Windows. And then I'm going to go back to see if there were any other steps we missed. So it says in the style/global.css, you have to add this. So I'm just going to go to styles/global.css, hit run over here. Okay, so it added something at the bottom. Great. I'm going to accept it and I'll save it. Okay, then it says test your website locally. Okay, sure, let's run this. Just gonna hit run over here. So let's see what happens. Great, now it's saying that it's available and it's ready at this location. It might be a little different port for you. I have a few other things open. There you go. So first attempt, we copied the code from V0, we pasted in Cursor, and look at that, amazing. So the whole thing is working, it's deployable for us. And let's see if the links work here. Yeah. Awesome. The next steps are to prepare for deployment. So it says to create a GitHub repo and then push the code. I'm going to assume that I have no understanding what's happening here. So I'm going to go down and ask for it to explain it to me. All right. So I'm saying explain this. I have no idea how to do this. So let's see what it says. Great, now we have some additional instructions. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna quickly follow these steps and come back to deploy or push our code online. So I made a new repo, I added the repo name and I'm gonna make it public. And then with that, I should be able to create a new repo now. So we have some instructions here. We're gonna go back to Cursor and follow the instructions from Cursor. Now we're supposed to open Terminal again. So I'm gonna go into the folder where my project is, and then I'm gonna run these commands. Now this is a command which is to add your particular repo. So I'm gonna go to GitHub, and in here I see that this is the name that I need to add. So I'm gonna copy that and go back and add that here. Okay, now I see that it has pushed the code. I'm gonna go to the repo and see if that's the case. And yes, we see that the original commit is available here. Great. Now the next steps are to create something on Vercel, sign up, create an account. So I already have an account. So now I logged into Vercel and then I had my GitHub account already connected. If not, you can just connect and it pulls all of the repos. So I'm gonna select the portfolio website. This is the one that we wanted to pull in here, and we can leave the default settings and then hit deploy. I'm just gonna hit deploy here. Now this takes a few seconds, so we're gonna come back once it's deployed. So we hit some error. What we're gonna do is we'll copy this and take it back to Cursor. So I'm saying getting this error on Vercel, and I'll paste all of that and let's see what it does. Okay, now it says that this is where we need to fix. So I'm just gonna hit apply and see what it does. There was this section which was causing the issue. I'm gonna accept, then save it. And now we're gonna follow the instructions that, okay, all of this was taken care of. Now I'm gonna go back and do this. I'm gonna try to run this whole thing this time. Let's see. Oh, nice. Okay, all of that went through. So I'm gonna quickly refresh this and see what happens. We know this worked. And now we go back to Vercel. Now I'm gonna try to deploy again and let's see what happens. Great. Now we see that the website is deployed and we can visit this website by clicking here. And there we go, folks. From an idea and just some prompts, we have a complete built website and it's deployed to the link that's available in our Vercel dashboard. This is absolutely amazing. We can prompt our way to building amazing websites like this, and we don't necessarily have to code anything as you saw in this tutorial. In the next video, we're gonna look into all of these details as what they mean and how you can get the most out of Cursor. This was just the beginning for you to get started with Cursor, and we're going to build some amazing web applications. Follow along.